welcome to the Waters Demo Lab. Thank you for coming today. We've invited you here to demonstrate the Waters BioAccord, which is the first smart MS-enabled LC-MS system developed specifically for biopharmaceutical analysis and monitoring. The goal of the system was to develop an easy-to-use platform so that analysts can routinely obtain high-quality data on different attributes of their molecules. These attributes can then be used to monitor the molecule throughout the different stages of the development process. For example, from clone selection through to late development and QC. So the BioAccord is a robust, easy to use platform that even new MS users can use to obtain high quality data so that you can make quicker decisions and reduce bottlenecks in their daily routines. I'm now going to take you up to the system so we can look at it in more detail and explain the individual components. So this is the BioAccord system. It's made up of a Acuity iClass Plus UPLC system with a column heater and a TV detector. And at the heart of the system is the Acuity RDA time of flight mass spectrometer. The RDA has a front panel here which indicates the state of the system, whether it's ready, running, or it has an error to check. The fluidics bottles here can be made up using kits that you can buy directly on the Waters website along with any standards or columns, and they're very easy to prepare.
How easy is it for a user to get the system ready to acquire data?
Okay, so if you'd like to come back to the computer with me and I'll show you how to do a system setup. So setting up the system is a simple one-click operation, and it includes an auto-tune and a mass calibration up to 7,000 M over Z. And this process just takes a few minutes. So that's how straightforward it is to set up the system.
So how do we actually acquire the data?
Okay, so I'll take you through the acquisition process. So the whole system is controlled by Unify software. So from acquisition through to processing and reporting, everything's done in Unify. And this means that data integrity and compliance is taken care of. So I'll now show you how to set up an acquisition. So if we go create analysis, I'm going to create a new sample list and use an intact MAB method. Then give the file a name, choose the online system, and then we just need to populate the sample list and press go. So we're going to inject NISMAB twice. We're going to set the first injection to be a reference so we can do a comparison. We're going to inject 4 microliters of the NISMAB. So once that's all set up, it's just a case of pressing go. So we're going to run samples, we're going to process the data and generate a report. So we're just looking at the real-time acquisition now. So we can see we've got the TIC trace up and we're just waiting for the MAB peak to elute. Okay, so we can see the peaks come off at 2.25 minutes. So we can do a manual integration while it's running. And here we can see we have the multiply charged spectrum of the intact MAB. And we can zoom in and look at the individual glycoforms. So the software will automatically deconvolute and identify this spectrum in the processing stage, which is what we're going to look at next. So now we have the results from that intact acquisition. So the data's been processed. So in the component summary table, we can see we've identified the major glycoforms, and we have a percentage which corresponds to the ratios of these glycoforms. We've got the integrated UV and TIC chromatograms, and over here we have the deconvoluted spectrum. If we click onto the next step in our workflow, which is a component plot, we can see here we've identified the major components in the deconvoluted spectrum, and these could be used as attributes for monitoring.
So that was intact mass analysis. What about peptide monitoring?
Okay, so the system is set up to do peptide mapping and monitoring experiments. So if we click onto this experiment here, we have a peptide map experiment of trastuzumab. So we have a slightly different workflow here. So in the review tab, we're looking at the coverage map, which indicates the level of coverage from the triptych peptides. We have here a annotated fragmentation spectrum. And we have information in the review table which corresponds to the peptide name, the mass error, and the percentage modified. So, for example, if we wanted to look at a particular peptide to monitor, we could choose that by doing a reference comparison. So here we have a comparison between trastuzumab and a biosimilar version of trastuzumab. So if we zoom into a particular area of interest on the chromatogram, we can see that around 9 minutes, we have a peak that's present in the biosimilar trastuzumab that's not present in the reference trastuzumab. If we go on to the next step in the workflow, which is sequence variants, this is how we monitor that particular peptide over a batch of samples. And we've applied some limits here so that if the response to that particular peptide or the percentage amount goes above a certain threshold, it will turn red. And if we click on this limit function here, it will highlight the samples for which that particular parameter has exceeded the threshold. Okay. So this is peptide mapping. We also have the set up to do released end glycan analysis. So I'm just going to quickly show you an experiment where we have labelled the released glycans with Rapiflor MS. Okay, and again, we have the glycans from trastuzumab. So the way in which this workflow works is by determining the GU value from a dextran calibration. The GU value is then used to search a library. The library search results that come back, first of all by GU value, are then mass confirmed. So here we have a fully annotated fluorescence chromatogram. And in the review table, we have the percentage amount for each glycan across a batch of samples, again, which is useful for the monitoring type applications. So the system has been designed for maximum uptime and robustness, and in keeping with this, we developed a health system which contains self-diagnostics that will alert the user if anything needs to be checked and take them through a step-by-step process which enables them to fix the issue and then carry on acquiring data. Okay, so I'm now going to go to the system and create a fault so we can see how the software guides us through in a step-by-step way, allowing us to fix the fault and move on. So if we look at the front panel, we can now see that the status says check, and it's giving an indication as to the location of the system where we need to check. I'm now going to come back to the computer and we can see the step-by-step guidance on how to remedy the fault. So it's telling us now that the leak sensor isn't fitted. If we click here to see more information, it's telling us where about the leak sensor is and how to check it so that we can do that. So I'm going to go back to the instrument now and follow this step. Now we've fixed the fault and we're ready to acquire data again. Thank you for visiting the Waters Demo Lab today. I've demonstrated that the Waters BioAccord smartms-enabled LCMS system is a robust and easy-to-use platform for biopharmaceutical analysis and monitoring.